Morning guys, got up a bit late today, but it was a late night last night, so probably needed it. What am I doing today? I'm going to head to the Forbidden City and probably Tiananmen Square today. So yeah, I was speaking to the guys last night and they said it's amazing, so yeah, looking forward to it. So now all we've got to do is find it. Just got off the tube, arrived at Tiananmen Square. Just as I was getting out of the tube, or like on the exit, a woman sort of grabbed me and started walking with me, a Chinese woman, spoke perfect English, started telling me about everything and stuff like that, asked me where I'm from and everything like that. And yeah, as I was walking down to it, down towards the square, she's like, oh, I can show you West Coast. Like, okay. And he's like, oh, why don't we go in this store? She kept trying to drag me into each store, so I'm guessing she was probably a tour guide. So I kind of tried to shake her and I managed it. So, but I might be wrong, she might have just been like a really nice person, but by a tourist attraction, someone comes straight up to you and starts talking to you and tries to drag you into every shop, kind of start thinking a little bit. So yeah, I just got to try and find the entrance. Apparently it's down here on the left, so we'll see. So I think my suspicions were correct. As I come up, some other woman just came up to me and said basically exactly the same thing. Oh, let's go in this store and talk about stuff. And so yeah, just be careful if you're coming around the tourist attraction in China. So it turns out she led me in completely the wrong direction. I have to walk in. I can probably see the metro station from like the entrance that I'm at now. I've just had to walk like 10-15 minutes like through the grounds to get to it, and I could have just crossed the road. So yeah, I've got to go down and buy a ticket so I can go all the way back again to go inside. So thank you very much, short Chinese woman who tried to drag me into a shop. Obviously tried to sell me a tour. Okay, so I made it into the Forbidden City. Now I said I was going to Tiananmen Square, but I think something got lost in translation. Yeah, it's huge. Look at it. Absolutely massive. And this is just like the entrance. It's absolutely massive. But yeah, it was a bit confusing, because I got off at a Tiananmen Square stop on the metro, so I kind of expect this to be Tiananmen Square. And then there were signs for Forbidden City, which I'm pretty sure this is. But it's not actually called the Forbidden City and the tourist stuff. Like when you buy tickets, it's called the Palace Museum. So I was like, huh? So I saw the ticketing booth and they said tickets for the Palace Museum. I was like, I don't want to go into the museum, I just want to go into the Forbidden City. So, but no, apparently this is the Palace Museum, like Forbidden City, so, I know, awesome place. That place is huge. Like Buckingham Palace of Shame. Yeah, there's a pagoda up on the hill, just behind it. So I'm gonna walk up the hill. Hopefully get a good view of the whole place. Just walking down by the river outside Forbidden City. People over there fishing, like just in the middle of the city. There's someone doing it yesterday at the park that I went to, and he got told off for it. But the police are doing it here, so I'm guessing it's okay. Made it into Tiananmen Square, and I think these are all the government buildings. The security around here is really, really high. National Museum behind me. Don't know what that is over there. And I'm guessing that's the government building. And on that side, you've got Forbidden City. massive square. That's Tiananmen Square done. There's not a lot here, there's lots of big buildings and a few statues and stuff like that. It's alright, I suppose, it's something to come to after the Forbidden City, or before. I was going to come here before, but some woman dragged me off, so. Yeah, going to head back to my hostel now. Probably going to try and get an early night tonight, because I'm going to the wall tomorrow and I'll leave at 6:30 in the morning. And I'll be out all day as well, so. And then, oh no, it's only 11 tomorrow, it's okay. So yeah, I'm going to be knackered if I stay up too late. But yeah, I'm going to edit some of my videos, try and get some of them online now. I found a way to get online. So, not sure what's going on here at the minute, actually. There's loads of cars just pulled up. I haven't got a clue what they're for. No one really got out any drivers, so there's no one in them, no one important, I don't think. So yeah, gonna head back to the hostel, finish editing the videos. I'm so behind. I think I'm halfway through editing day 4. It's now day 12, I think. But after day 4, I get on a Trans-Siberian, so hopefully that's a big block of about 6 days that I should be able to catch up with. So you're gonna head back, edit, upload, and get an early night.